climate modeling research indicates that Venus could be a lovely place to visit. With a time machine. Earth and Venus are each about 4.5 billion years old. Although Venus is a veritable hellscape today, it's good to keep in mind that Earth was probably equally uninhabitable for about 1 billion years. It got better. And according to a new study out of NASA's Goddard Institute for Space Studies, Venus has changed too. It may have been habitable to life as we know it for up to 2 billion years of its history. Venus today is exactly the kind of place that humans don't want to hang out. There's practically no water because the surface temperature can reach 462 degrees Celsius. That's 864 degrees Fahrenheit, which is the perfect temperature to cook a crispy Neapolitan pizza, and more than hot enough to melt aluminum. The atmospheric pressure on its surface is 90 times that of Earth's, meaning the very air would crush you. And by air, I mean mostly carbon dioxide. Researchers also think Venus's thick clouds discharge more lightning than we see on Earth, and those clouds are made of sulfuric acid. But as recently as 715 million years ago, Venus may have had shallow oceans and an atmosphere comparable to Earth's today, with mean temperatures a few degrees cooler than ours even. The team from NASA adapted the climate modeling tools used here on Earth to create a 3D climate simulation for ancient Venus. They built the model based on data and hypotheses from NASA's Pioneer and Magellan space probes and the ESA's Venus Express orbiter. They found that even though its distance from the sun means that ancient Venus would have received about 40% more sunlight than Earth does today, Venus's global temperatures were likely mitigated by its incredibly slow rotation rate. A day on Venus lasts about 117 Earth days. Its day side receives sun exposure for about 2 Earth months at a time. In the simulation, that produced thick rain clouds that shielded the surface and kept the planet temperate. These results are dependent on Venus's topography and rotation rate not changing much over the past few billion years, which is actually likely, but it's still in question. So the team played around with the model to see whether feasible topographical or rotational adjustments could have changed their results. Increasing the steepness of the mountains and ocean basins to Earth-type levels raised the temperatures in the model, but they did stay within a life-friendly range. Speeding the rotational rate only made the model too hot for life when they made Venus's days 7 times shorter, a mere 16 Earth days per single Venus day as opposed to 117. The research is thought-provoking on its own. Ancient Earth, sponges, and algae may have had neighbors in our solar system, but it's really part of NASA's push to identify exoplanets capable of harboring life as we know it. We previously thought planets as close to a star as Venus may have always been too hot to support life, but now we can expand our search. But what do you think? Where could the search for extraterrestrial life take us? Get in touch and let us know. If you're into that whole podcast thing, take an auditory gander at HowStuffWorks now for a wrap-up of all of our stories every week. And to keep up with lots more going on in our weird world, head on over to now.howstuffworks.com.